family respectfully welcomes you on this second Sunday of Easter. The order for morning prayer, right one, begins on page 1 of your prayer booklet or on page 37 of the book of common prayer.
I was glad
when they said unto me, "We will go into the house of the Lord." The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth be silent before him. Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own heart. We have offended against thy holy law. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. We have done those things which we ought not to have done. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare thou those who confess their faults. Restore thou those who are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind, through Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. The Almighty and merciful Lord grant us absolution and remission of all our sins, true repentance, amendment of life, and the grace and consolation of his Holy Spirit. Amen. Please stand. Lord, open now our lips, and our mouth shall show forth thy praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. Let us now say together the Benedictus. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and show ourselves glad in him with song. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all the corners of the earth, and the strength of the hills is his also. The sea is his, and he made it, and his hands prepared the dry land. O come, let us worship and fall down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is the Lord our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. O worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth stand in awe of him. For he cometh to judge the earth, and with righteousness to judge the world, and the people of this truth. Please remain standing as we say together Psalm 133, as found on page 2 of your booklet insert. Oh, how good and pleasant it is when brethren live together in unity. It is like fine oil upon the head that runs down upon the beard, upon the beard of Aaron, and runs down the collar of his robe. It is like the dew of honey that falls upon the hills of Zion. For there the Lord has ordained his blessing, life forevermore.
Glory to the Father,
and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles.
Now the whole group of those who believed were one heart and soul, And no one claims private ownership of any possession, but everything they own is held in common. With great power, the apostles gave their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. There was not a needy person among them, for as many as owned lands or houses sold them, and bought the proceeds of what was sold. They laid it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to each as any had need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand as you are able and let us say together a song of praise.
Blessed art
thou, O Lord God of our fathers, praised and exalted above all forever. Blessed art thou for the name of thy majesty, praised and exalted above all forever. Blessed art thou in the temple of thy holiness, praised and exalted above all forever. Blessed art thou that beholdest the dead and dwellest between the cherubim, praised and exalted above all forever. Blessed art thou on the glorious throne of thy kingdom, praised and exalted above all forever. Blessed art thou in the firmament of heaven, praised and exalted above all forever. Blessed art thou, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, praised and exalted above all forever.
John. We declare to you what was from the beginning, what we have heard, what we have seen with our eyes, and what we have looked at and touched with our hands, concerning the word of life. This life was revealed, and we have seen it and testified to it, and declare to you the eternal life that was with the Father and was revealed to us. We declare to you what we have seen and heard, so that you also may have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. We are writing these things so that our joy may be complete. This is the message we have heard from him and proclaim to you, that God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him while we are walking in darkness, we lie and do not do what is true. But if we walk in the light, as he himself is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of his Son cleanses us from all sin. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sin, he is faithful and just, will forgive us our sin and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. The word of the Lord.
Please stand as you are able and let us say together the song of Mary. My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior. For he hath regarded the lowliness of his handmaid. For behold, from henceforth all generations will call me blessed. For he that is mighty hath magnified me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on him that fear him throughout all generations. He hath showed strength with his arm. He hath scattered the clouds in the imagination of their hearts. He hath put down the mighty from their seat, and hath exalted the humble and meek. He hath filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he hath sent empty away. He remembers his mercy, hath hope in his servant Israel, as he promised to our forefathers, Abraham and his seed forever.
Glory to the Father,
to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Thank you.
are written, so that you may come to believe
that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing, you can have life in his name.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. What is spoken and what is heard, may the word of God be understood. In the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Imagine,
if you will, you're located in the city of Jerusalem, the living, beating heart of the Jewish community, and under the ironclad rule of the Roman Empire. You and your friends have gone into a locked room.
The man
that you spent the last 3 years traveling around and through Galilee, Samaria, and Judea, whom you have seen performing many miracles,
and healing
the sick and the lame,
as well as all these
people, the pathway to eternal life, who you knew was the Messiah, the Son of God,
had been betrayed
and executed.
But not just executed,
executed by way of crucifixion.
According to
our gospel reading from John this morning, this is the reality that the disciples have found themselves in. I would imagine that they were truly afraid in that moment. Afraid for their own lives. Afraid of what the next hour, the next day, or even the next year would be like.
They grieve
the death of their friend and teacher.
And they probably felt
too lost
and completely hopeless. And at this point in time,
did not yet truly comprehend
the true purpose
of Jesus' death,
that it was required
for the forgiveness of sin of the world.
Yet, in just
the blink of an eye, a miracle happened.
Jesus
appeared in this lost room.
And he spoke his first word
to them.
Peace be with you. At that very moment,
how much love, compassion, and gratitude do you suppose that the disciples felt then and there, comforted by Jesus' words?
Now, we have just
walked through the season of Lent.
We all felt
the pain, the loss, and the emptiness that the disciples have experienced here. And I imagine that just about every person in this church has, at some point in time, felt the same pain of grief, the fear of the unknown, and the vastness of being alone.
Yet we, as disciples of Christ,
have some idea of the healing, comforting peace that can only be brought from Jesus.
Just about
every Sunday, we get to pass the peace. Now, for some, this is an opportunity to extend forgiveness and reconciliation to one another.
For others,
this is a joyous time. It's a time full of smiles, of hugs, and of laughter.
But unfortunately,
and truly grace that Jesus' peace can and will bring.
And just like the disciples in the reading,
we as the disciples of Christ have had the Holy Spirit breathe onto each and every one of us.
And just like those
disciples in the reading, Jesus' words still ring just as true for us. As the Father has sent me, so I send you.
We have got to
learn to take the peace that we experience every week
out of the walls
of this beautiful church
and share this
with the entire world.
Now,
we don't know another person's story. Truth be told, we don't even know our own story completely. The only one that knows this is God. We don't know what another person is experiencing. They may be feeling the pain of a loved one in the process of dying, or the acute emptiness of that loved one having just passed.
You don't know if
the scars that you see on the person sitting next to you were inflicted by that person as a cry for help, or by somebody that they thought they loved and were loved by.
It's all too easy for us
to see a homeless person
on the street, dirty,
scared, and in need,
and for us
to turn and walk the other way.
Or worse, just walk by
before you might find out and pretending you're not even there.
I would like
to offer a challenge
to everybody that
is listening to this, here in person or in the virtual world. When we leave here, I would like for you to tell just one person. Just one person.
You don't know
if that small phrase might just be what puts a smile on somebody's face that hasn't smiled in a long while.
Or it just might be the
words that remind a lost soul
that Jesus loves
them. That by Jesus' death, their sins have been forgiven.
And bring them back
to Jesus' love and grace.
I know that this world
that we live in makes it difficult to truly interact with one another.
But this is just one of the barriers
that we must begin to overcome.
And this isn't a process
that can happen overnight. It's going to take time, maybe even lifetime.
But if we
just start by showing Jesus' love and peace, by just telling that one person, peace be with you,
well, then we will have made
this world a much better place. So I will simply close it
by saying,
may the peace of God be with you forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Please stand as you are able
and let us say together the Apostles' Creed on page 6 in the morning prayer booklet. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, and his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary,
judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And also with you.
And his praise.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. O Lord, show the mercy upon us, and grant us thy salvation, and do thy ministers with righteousness. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world. Lord, keep this nation under thy care. Let thy way be known upon earth. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten. Create in us clean hearts, O God.
Almighty and everlasting
God, who in the Paschal mystery established a new covenant of reconciliation, grant that all who have been reborn into the fellowship of Christ's body may show forth in their lives what they profess by their faith, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, Almighty and everlasting God, who has safely brought us to the beginning of this day, defend us in the same with thy mighty power, and grant that this day we fall into no sin, neither run into any kind of danger, but that we, being ordered by thy governance, may do always what is righteous and right through Jesus Christ our Lord. Lord Jesus Christ, who did stretch out thine arms of love on the high wooden cross, that everyone might come within the reach of thy saving grace, so clothe us in thy spirit that we, reaching forth our left hand in love, may bring those who do not know thee to the knowledge and love of thee, for the honor of thy name.
Heavenly Father,
hear our prayers of intercession and thanksgiving on behalf of this congregation. We pray especially for the church and for the world. And grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. We pray especially for Justin, our Bishop of Canterbury, Michael, our presiding bishop, Colton, our bishop, Daniel, Bishop of Uruguay, Sammy, our priest, and Bobby, our deacon, and the clergy and people of the Diocese of Oklahoma and our companion Diocese of Uruguay. On this day, the Lord has acted. Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. We pray especially for Joe, our president, Kevin, our governor, and Trey, our mayor. On this day, the Lord has acted. Give us all reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. On this day, the Lord has acted. Bless all whose lives are closer linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. On this day, the Lord has acted. Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their trouble, and bring them the joy of your salvation.
In our diocesan
cycle of prayer, we pray for all souls of the Holy City. In our parish cycle of prayer, we pray for Danny and Brandon Paycheffer, and for Stan, Yana, and Hannah Millen, and for Trish Armstrong.
For those serving our
country at home or abroad, not fashion, becoming known. We also pray for our veterans, especially those still struggling with wartime wounds. Let them feel your comfort and healing grace.
For those who are in hospital,
for those who need healing, Avery Anderson, River Northcutt, Jasper Sonke, Ed Anderson, Doug Boucher, Jay Kohler, Susan Morgell, Rob Newcomer, Linda Newcomer, John Epperly, Carolyn Murphy, Mary Criswell, Tom Crager, Richard Johnson, Christine Andrews.
I ask your prayer for
the departed. Pray for those who have died, especially Daniel Taylor, and for the bereaved, for the family and friends of Daniel, especially Kate Taylor. We pray for those celebrating birthdays this week, Angus McFarlane, John Morrell, and Mal Taylor, and for those celebrating the anniversary, Michael and Katrina and Patricia Pearson.
Praise God for those
in every generation in whom Christ has been honored, especially Dr. Clarence and Mary Jo Taylor, and Carl Baxter and Virginia Thompson, in whose loving memory the altar flags were given by Greg and Jane Taylor. Pray that we may have grace to glorify Christ on our own day.
Grant these
our prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Good morning, everyone. Good to see everybody here today, and welcome those that are joining us on Facebook as well. Mother Tammy has taken a well-deserved Sunday off after her first full week of Holy Week and Easter, and so she took the day off, and I would say it's really well-deserved. So, I didn't notice any announcements from the bulletin today, but I'm sure all the normal weekly activities will resume this week. We'll have a service on Wednesday. And I don't know if there's any Matthew this week. Are there any other announcements?
It's good to see everybody.
It seems like we're getting more and more folks back. So just appreciate you being here. It's good to see everybody. The walk in love is Christ's love. He gave himself for us an offering and a sacrifice to God.
And we'll continue with
the general thanksgiving. Almighty God, Father of all men, we, thy unworthy servants, we give thee most humble and hearty thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness to us and to all men. We bless thee for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for thy inestimable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ. For the means of grace, for the hope of glory, and we beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercy, that our hearts may be unfeignedly thankful, and that we show forth thy praise not only with our lips, but in our hearts, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time of one accord to make our common supplication unto thee, and has promised to thy well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, thou wilt be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting. Amen.
Let us bless
the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore. Come back and visit us. We would like to have you today.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah.